So someone asked about cluster headache, and cluster headache is associated with a sign, which is ipsilateral Horner syndrome, which is going to be a meiosis, a smaller pupil. There's going to be anisocoria, different size pupil, and that anisocoria is going to be greater in the dark because it's a sympathetic problem. And there's going to be a ptosis, usually only 1 to 2 millimeters, and an upside down ptosis from the sympathetically innervated muscle in the lower lid. The upper lid sympathetic muscle is the Mueller's muscle. So when you have a Horner syndrome, that is an oculosympathetic defect. That oculosympathetic defect is associated with the autonomic headache syndrome called cluster. The mechanism of this is presumably because the autonomics to the eye are surrounding the internal carotid artery. And so that vascular headache can cause a Horner syndrome. It's a diagnosis of exclusion because you need to make sure there's no structural lesion. And there have been patients, of course, who meet all the diagnostic criteria of cluster who have a structural Horner syndrome. To me, you should image that. Although this is controversial in the literature, I think if you have a cluster and a Horner's as a manifestation, that you should make sure it's not a carotid dissection. So that's in the same localization, presumably. The thing that causes the Horner's and the cluster is the same thing that causes the headache in a mimicking a cluster from an internal carotid cervical artery carotid dissection. So we always image these Horner syndromes, even if it's in the setting of cluster, but if it's negative and they otherwise meet the diagnostic criteria, then we call it cluster headache.